and it starts here in the 16th and 17th fret. So it's mostly alternating picking until you get to this part here, down by the 5th fret, and I'll make note of that. I'll tell you when we get to that section that's not alternating picking anymore. Okay, so it starts out like this. Whoops. 16th, 17th fret. That's the whole song played slowly, and it's the introduction. The verses are a little bit different. Maybe I'll show that in a different video, but today just the introduction. Okay, so nice and slowly, the first part here, 16th, 17th fret. Whoops. Alternating picking, so up, down picking. Start with a down pick. All in the D string here. 16, 17, 14, 16, 12. 16, 17, 14, 16, 12. Okay, next section, I'll build off this one. Okay, 11, 12, 9, 11, 7. And you go back on the 9 there, 7, 9. Okay, and then things change when you hit the 5th. I'll show you how. You actually stop in the 5th, and you down pick twice. You go 5th down pick, and then 4 down pick. So I'll show you. Down. Down. So it's alternating picking up until then. Do it nice and slowly. And when you get to this section, the next section is down pick, down. So 5th down, 4th fret down. And it goes like this. So you're moving for the first time from the D string to the A string here. So 4-5-4-5 on the D string, 4 back on the A string, or the D string, sorry. 4-5-4-5 on the A string, playing a D, then back to the note here. Okay. Then use your pinky. You can, if you want. If you don't know how to use your pinky, you don't want to use it. You can use your ring finger. But I think that's a bit awkward. I think it's easy to use your pinky. So this is good practice for your pinky. So, pinky, 5-4-5-7-5-4-5, all the way up to 9 with your pinky. 7-7 with your middle finger. And then that section, that whole section is played a second time with a slightly different ending, and that's the introduction. You just play those two things, that what I just showed you, and you'll play the second part, which I'll show you again. You play them alternating a couple times. You play one, then you play the second. I guess that's it. But then that's the bridge between every verse as well. And then there's also the stuff you do in the actual singing of the song. But you could argue what you really need to know are those parts. If you want to just play the song, know those two parts. And everything else, you can kind of just strum chords. I think most of the song you can strum in just one chord, just the D chord. Okay, so this is the second part. The second part's just like the first for most of it. It's just the last few notes that are different. So. That's how it differs. The other one goes. This one goes. Otherwise, the second part is the same as the first. So I'll do it nice and slow here for you. It's very, very slow. You can follow along. That's it. Now, the last thing I'll say is when I play this song, there are little embellishments. This is for more advanced players, which I don't really need to show this to. But if you're an intermediate player and you kind of want to build it up, I'll just show it with the little embellishments. I won't play too fast. Show the little embellishments there, just really quick hammer-ons. You can't really do them in the song unless they're fast enough, because if you do them too slowly, it'll break the time of the song. This is a Beckico, you have to play it at a constant speed, and those little hammer-ons can throw the timing off a bit. And in fact, this is an easy song, but once you add those embellishments, it's really, really hard, because you have to get that right. You really do. But when you're playing it, remember, once you get down here, you can do this. That's the kind of, gives it that old school arabetica sound. So anyway, there you go. Good luck.